Hello, this is Mark from MWB Arts, and today I am going to do a dirty pour. I just got some new product in today. It is the Golden's Mediums Polymer Medium Gloss. Let's see if I can get that underneath there. It's Polymer Medium Gloss. Anyway, I got a gallon of that. I've been using PVA glue before that with success. And we just got some of this to hold us over until we get some Liquitex pouring medium. But right now I am mixing some colors. So far I have mixed the Hooker's Green Basics. I have mixed the Primary Yellow Basics. And some Copper Basics. Very metallic-y looking. And some unbleached Titanium White. And now for the last color, I'm doing some titanium white acrylic. And so I've already mixed up the other ones. And basically what I did is I filled these little cups here. You know, some of them only half full, some three-fourths full, like the whites, three-fourths full. The other ones half full, and then added the color in. And then I'm going to mix them all into my bigger cup and in a certain order. And I will explain that order as I do it. But for now, I'll finish mixing my white here. I need to put a little couple globs of the white in there. There we go. That should be good. And thin it down to the right consistency. I've been adding some squirts of water with my little pipette eyedropper type thing. And for now, let me finish mixing up my last one here. Oops, where did my stirring stick go? There we go. Okay, here's one that has not been used on any of the other colors right now. So, plans for this one. I was thinking getting some coppery, ribbony look in it, hopefully. And, I love the way the unbleached titanium white looks in it. And between that and the white is the main colors. And adding some of the green, the yellow, and the copper might make for an interesting look. We'll find out. Only time will tell. So if you see this video, then it was, I liked it, and it was success enough for me. And hopefully you like it. But if you don't see this video, then hey, it didn't turn out. I might share the photo, but so let me get this white stirred in, so it looks like it needs to thin down a little bit more. Because I think this white here was the artist white, so it's going to be a little bit thicker, so it's going to need a little more water. So in the other colors, I probably took the pipette and, you know, filled it up a quarter of the way, squirted some in, stirred it, and a quarter again, and stirred it, and that was about enough, really, to get it thin enough to for the pouring consistency. This one's going to take a little bit more water, I think. Hopefully I got enough space in my little cup here. I might have to pour some of it out to another cup if I got too much in here. Or I can, yeah. Hopefully I have enough space on this little cup. So I've been having fun with the pouring mediums. Different ones, experimenting. You know, I've experimented PVA, I've experimented just half and half by weight, paint and water. And I've used even resin, I think artist resin before. And I've experimented on different things like the Upo paper and canvas. And one was on a Upo paper mounted to a canvas board. This time I am doing it on an 8x8 wood, what were they called? 8x8 wood canvas look. It's the 1.5 inch thick in depth wood canvas. You can, you know, nice solid wood. And so let's see if I can get this. Oh. Needs a little more water in there. And so, I'll share the initial results of it with my voice, but maybe a lot of it I might just have music over it for the actual moving around, and but I'll have it the regular speed, that way you can see the full thing. It shouldn't take too long once it gets going here. So I think check and see here. Sometimes it's easier to check with a stick to see if it's pouring good. Yeah, it looks like it's pouring pretty good. I think I got it thin enough. There we go. So now I am going to try something different that I haven't tried before. Okay, so take the white and pour a little bit of that into the my little, oops, into my little cup here. Put that cup up there. Pour that in first. And there we go. And white's going to be the main color I have here. So, and now some of the titanium white. Good percentage of that one in. And then a little bit of the yellow, I think. Ooh. Some of the green next. Make sure I get that green stirred in. I think it's thin enough. Ooh, yeah. And some of the copper. Let me get that copper stirred a little bit more. So there's the copper. Color stirred in there good. It's kind of reacting to the water, it's milky, so I want to make sure it's stirred up really good with that, so it's more copper looking. So then I'll pour some of that copper in there now. Ooh, there we go. And now we'll pour some more of the titanium white on top of that again. And some of the I think that's just a little and some more of the white now. So that's the bleach I just put in. So now I'm pouring some of the white in. Oops. Okay, so I'm gonna take here a stick and slice it through once that way and once that way. Get those colors there going. And I'm hoping I got enough in there. I may not have enough. Let me put some more copper in there. And a little more of the yellow in there. And more of the green in there. Okay, oops. That's okay. And stick that stick through it once here. Okay. So, now, what I want to do is get this all lined up at the center, and I got the extra colors if I don't have enough, which it may happen that I don't have enough. Put this in the middle and flip it over and make sure it's on those cups good. Okay, I'm out of the camera. We'll let this sit for a while. We'll see how it turns out in a second here. Letting the paint drip off the sides and down the cup. Give it a couple more seconds. Okay. gonna try to do this without moving too much on here, but you know, pour it around a little bit, but if I see something I really like, I'm just gonna leave it that way. And yeah, see what we get. I have a straw ready. Let's see, where is that straw? The straw ready, just in case I'm gonna do any manipulating with that. And should be close. Get ready to be able to lift up this cup here. And ready, set, and go. Oh yeah, I think I got plenty of paint on here.
Thank you.
Okay, I think this is going to be it. Okay, so thank you for watching this. This is Mark from MWB Arts saying if you liked what you see here, click that like button and make a comment about it if you have any comments. This was using the Golden Polymer Medium Gloss today with a little bit of water and acrylic basic paints. The colors will be in the description. They were the primary yellow, the hooker's green, copper, and the unbleached titanium in the acrylic Liquitex Basics, and in the titanium white, it was the artist color. Yeah, so far I am liking this color scheme. No silicone was added, and I got some nice cool ribbony looks, and we'll see what it looks like when it dries. Like I said, I haven't tried this medium before, porn medium, but other people have it with success, and I think I got sides covered enough, and okay, I hope you enjoyed this video, and sounded kind of interesting to see a color scheme like this. I'll hold it up one more time without changing it too much, just so you can see it under this lighting. It's a little bit harsh lighting, but there you go. You see the copper on the edges there, the dark green, the white. You can see the buff. You can see the yellow in there. And some of the green actually mingled with the yellow and got lighter. Yeah. So, hope you like this. Interesting color scheme. New for me. And hopefully new for some of you out there. And go out there and put some color into things that you do today. And just have fun creating. Thanks a lot. Bye. Hello, this is Mark from MWB Arts, and today I am going to do a dirty pour. I just got some new product in today. It is the Golden's Mediums Polymer Medium Gloss. Let's see if I can get that underneath there. It's Polymer Medium Gloss. Anyway, I got a gallon of that. I've been using PVA glue before that with success. And we just got some of this to hold us over until we get some Liquitex pouring medium. But right now I am mixing some colors. So far I have mixed the Hooker's Green Basics. I have mixed the Primary Yellow Basics. And some Copper Basics. Very metallic-y looking. And some Unbleached Titanium White. And now for the last color, I'm doing some titanium white acrylic. And so, I've already mixed up the other ones. And basically, what I did is I filled these little cups here. You know, some of them only half full, some three-fourths full, like the whites, three-fourths full. The other ones half full, and then added the color in. And then I'm going to mix them all into my bigger cup and in a certain order. And I will explain that order as I do it. But for now, I'll finish mixing my white here. I need to put a little couple globs of the white in there. There we go. That should be good. And thin it down to the right consistency. I've been adding some squirts of water with my little pipette eyedropper type thing. And for now, let me finish mixing up my last one here. Oops, where did my stirring stick go? There we go. Okay, here's one that has not been used on any of the other colors right now. So, plans for this one. I was thinking getting some coppery, ribbony look in it, hopefully. And, I love the way the unbleached titanium white looks in it. And between that and the white is the main colors. And adding some of the green, the yellow, and the copper might make for an interesting look. We'll find out. Only time will tell. So if you see this video, then it was, I liked it, and it was success enough for me. And hopefully you like it. But if you don't see this video, then hey, it didn't turn out. I might share the photo, but